My name is Joel Patrick, Director of Solutions Engineering at Beyond Trust. This short video will be going over some of the mobile features in remote support. Some of these features include screen sharing, camera sharing, accessing the file store, and photo sharing. In this session that we'll be using, I'm going to go ahead and generate a session key that I could then give to a customer as part of this remote support session. We could go ahead and send an email to this mobile device. I could send this as a text message. But in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and enter that 7-digit number onto that mobile device. Simple click of a button, start screen sharing. And you may or may not have your site configured for prompting. I do have mine set for prompting, so the end user has to accept the incoming session. But again, at this point here, I'm connecting to that mobile device, had a pre-installed client, very, very quick, very, very easy. Customer can click their home button. You're seeing what's on the screen. Customer can hit their applications. We're seeing that. We could even go so far, you know, as to manage the settings or go to the Play Store or download an application. So again, this is just giving me kind of very, very quick and easy access to this mobile device. Now, my other mobile device that we're going to go ahead and connect to is going to be my iOS device. Apple is a little bit more stringent about what they allow, but in this case, we're going to go ahead and enter a session key. Again, I'm just going to go ahead and type that instead of taking the time to send an email to my mobile device. Go ahead and hit submit on the screen. I know you're not seeing the screen quite yet. And so initially, we'll be go ahead and connecting to the mobile device, but strictly with our application. So again, I have customer prompting before I actually jump into the session. So let's go ahead and send the customer the instructions for how to receive support. So the instructions tell the customer, please click this little button right here. And then after you click that button, press the start broadcast. So I'll go ahead and close the instructions. I'll click on the broadcast and go ahead and hit start. So now what will happen is we'll be disconnected from the session. The broadcast is going to reconnect the client. And now, instead of connecting to our application, we are going to be connected to the actual stream that's coming from the operating system. So here in this case, we're reconnected to that session. Again, the iOS device is creating a stream and sending that stream here to our local application. I could go ahead and swipe up and you could see my home screen. I could go ahead and go to the settings tab if you wanted to see the settings. You could see my wireless settings. You could see my personal hotspot is off. So Apple is basically allowing us a view-only connection to this mobile device. Now, I could also go down here and click on files, and I could transfer files to the application. I could click on photos, and then the customer could choose what photos they are going to be wanting to share. Or we could also use the camera and be able to stream the camera of what is occurring on that remote device. So here in my case, if I have a customer who wants to troubleshoot an actual printer, so here I am enabling the screen sharing. It is sending the view of the printer. So maybe there is a printer jam, so I could have the customer open the door, maybe pull out the manual feed tray or pull out the toner cartridge. But again, with our camera sharing, you have the capability of streaming your session to the actual representative. Again, just a quick little video walking through our mobile support capabilities for both Android and iOS.